I am proceeding. Now we are going to discuss some special provisions relating to Cheque. Now let us discuss some special provisions relating to Cheque. Friends, tell me, when Cheque will be dishonored? First, no balance. Apron. Inappropriate. Signature is not there. Validity. Where the Cheque is damaged. Cheque is forged. No. Now, Mokka Pandara. Now. Next. When Cheque will be dishonored? Come on. Insolvent. Overreturn. Listen. I'll tell you an interesting thing. Earlier, what was the practice? Where you write a Cheque, and if there is any mistake in the Cheque, you just strike out the mistake, and then you write something above it. Near that you put your signature. The Cheque will be treated as valid. But some 1 to 1.5 years ago, RBI has come out with a clarification that the banks should not entertain such types of Cheques. So which means there should be no overwriting etc. in the Cheques. However, some banks, they are not strictly following it. Some banks, they are allowing it because of the relationship they have with their customers. But as per RBI regulations and the recent clarification which is given by RBI, if something is overwritten in the Cheque, it is not possible for you to overwrite something near that and then put your signature, all those stories, not possible. If you have done a mistake, cancel the Cheque and give a fresh Cheque. This is the clarification by RBI. Now, we will discuss, mark this as very to the whole power infinite important. I don't find any reason why institute is having so much of affinity towards this particular question. For every second or third attempt, this question comes. And when this question comes, it comes only for 8 marks and not less than 8 marks. Only for 8 marks, minimum 8 marks. So if you can answer this question, laddu. 8 marks will come and fall in your packet. Now, Cheque is dishonored. When Cheque will be dishonored? In material. Practically, some circumstances la, banks may dishonor, whereas in some other circumstances, banks shall dishonor. If you see practically, some circumstances la bank may dishonor, some circumstances la bank shall dishonor. I'll give you a small example. I am a customer with Indian Overseas Bank for the past 3 to 4 years. And in this entire past 3 to 4 years, I was one of the good customers where my balance never went below the minimum balance. And I always had sufficient funds in my account. And there is regular inflow of funds into that account. There is a regular dealing, regular transaction is taking place in that account. By mistake, I gave a Cheque. The income normally comes on 5th of a month. Whereas I dated this Cheque as 4th and then I gave the Cheque. Now when the Cheque goes for payment, there is no balance in the account. But I know the manager very well. Manager also knows me that 5th, the income will come into the fund. It will come into the account. Today is 4th. What the manager can do? He can allow the cheque. He need not dishonor this for insufficiency of funds. He can allow the cheque, because even if he is going to create a debit balance in my passbook, still the very next day the income is going to come and this debit balance is going to get converted into a credit balance. Come on, my dear friend. But there are some circumstances where the banker may dishonor. There are some circumstances where the banker shall dishonor. But as far as examination is concerned, the examination doesn't distinguish between may dishonor, shall dishonor. No such distinction in examination. So some authors, they write may dishonor, shall dishonor. We don't make such a difference. For examination, what is the thing? That is what we are discussing here. Everyone? Enappa? Now, what are all the circumstances under which the instrument can be dishonored? Number one, where the instrument is undated. Where the instrument is undated, or where the instrument is post-dated and presented for payment. Before the specified date. Where the instrument is post-dated and it is presented for payment before the specified date. Today I am giving you a check, and the date which is given in the check is 1st June. When you can go and present this check? On or after 1st June you can present the check. If you are going to present the check before 1st June, what the banker will do? He will dishonor. Respond, friends. Next. Where the cheque is presented after validity period here you need to note something important. Very recently, some 1 to 1.5 years ago, RBI reduced this validity period from 6 months to 3 months. Validity period is reduced from 6 months to 3 months. This may come in your examination. Why? Because this amendment has not yet been tested in the examination. Of course, May examination is there, but still, till this time this amendment has not been tested in the examination. Friends, another point to be understood here: what is the validity period? Validity period is 3 months, or the period mentioned in the instrument, whichever is less. Validity period is 3 months, or the period which is mentioned in the instrument, whichever is less. Understood? Sometimes in instrument, what he will do, no? At the place where we do crossing, he will cross the instrument as account payee, and below that he will write valid for 1 month. Below that he will write valid for 1 month. Now on the instrument or a lifetime in one. If nothing is given, 3 months. If some validity period is given, that shall be the validity period if that is lesser than 3 months. Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
Next. Not yet copied, Oh. Huh? 10:45 is the schedule. No. I am not lying. Oh, what message comes to me? That is the final. Satish. 10:30 or 10:45? 10:45. You all had your breakfast and then only you came, no? No problem. One day nothing will happen. Na. Era Kabir. Na volunteer edho satham urra. Na listen, listen. Come on, come on. I wasted 2 minutes in this. And I left you 2 minutes early. Come on. Where notice is received. What notice? Notice of insolvency. Notice of unsound mind. Notice of closure of accounts. Notice of stop payment. The stop payment, we call it as countermanding payment. Countermanding payment. The customer countermands the payment. Means what you should understand. The customer is doing a stop payment. Apron. Insolvency, financial debt. Unsound mind, mental debt. Physical death is also possible. Correct? Next. Where garnishee order is received from court. Now we should know what is this garnishee order. Yes or no? Garnishee order is nothing but freeze order from the court. Garnishee order is nothing but freeze order from the court. See, sometimes some persons are there, they are engaged in some illegal activities. Now what the courts will do? Courts will say from his account not even 1 rupee should be paid, freeze his account. Like this the courts will give direction to the banks. Yes or not? These types of order, they are called as garnishee order. Everyone. Next. Where there is insufficiency of funds. Where drawer's sign is forged. Or where there is material alteration where there is material alteration or where the cheque is defaced or torn or mutilated. What is this? Defaced, torn, mutilated. Listen, very simple. I was having an ink pen and I was dropping ink into this ink pen. What happened? Suddenly the ink leaked. Some paper I took and then I cleaned it. After that only I found out it is a cheque. But now what the cheque is? Defaced. Or sometimes I have the unique practice of keeping this cheque in packet and my mom has got the unique practice of washing the cheques also. So she puts it in a washing machine and then she says, what are you didn't see what it is? And then I take something in the shape of a cheque comes out. So this is called as cheque is defaced or the cheque is torn or the cheque is mutilated. I need to complete here. We cannot go in the, when we are having food, halfway we cannot go. Correct or not? Like that. Two or three more points alone. Where customer has account with one branch. And cheque is presented for payment in another branch. Where the customer is having account with one branch and the check is presented for payment in another branch. I gave you an example relating to this check. Do you remember? What example? HDFC Bank is there. State Bank of India is there. Yes or not? Take this illustration. SS is having two options. What are the two options he is having? Either he can come to SBI Nanganallur and he can get cash, or he can go to HDFC Bank Coimbatore, he can deposit. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
SS is going to SBI Coimbatore. They will give cash or they will not give cash? Huh? They will not give cash. Come on, friends.
Yes, sir.
Everyone. So where I am having account with one branch, but it is presented for payment in some other branch. Now that is not possible. Similarly, where the funds are not applicable for payment. Where the funds are not applicable for payment. Understood? Listen. I have borrowed rupees 40 lakhs from a bank for the purpose of housing loan. Come on, friend.
Yes, sir.
Today I am giving a check. When the housing loan amount will get debited, the housing loan amount will get debited on 16th of every month. Come on, friends. Today, every month, the housing loan amount, some 1 lakh rupees will get debited from my bank account towards this housing loan. Everyone?
Yes,
so now what I am doing, today I am giving a check to some other party. To some other party, to one of the service providers, I am giving a check of rupees 80,000. Balance in my bank account is only 1,20,000. Come on, yeah. Today is 12th, 16th, and 1 lakh should get debited towards the loan amount. What the banker will see? Banker will see first loan should be repaid to him, or using this amount he will repay some other person. Come on, yeah. Balance, how much I am having? 1,20,000 balance I am having. Now the bank is having an issue. What is the issue? In another 2 or 3 days, this 1,20,000 should be used for payment of his own loan account. Yes or not?
Yes,
but now what the banker will do? The banker will dishonor. The banker will dishonor. See, in another 2 or 3 days, the loan amount should be debited. Now you are giving a check of 80,000. If we debit this 80,000, what will we do for the loan amount? Everyone. So thereby what the banker will do, these funds, the fund of 1,20,000 is not applicable. It will not apply for this payment. This should be applied. This should be appropriated only towards the payment of my loan account. Like this the banker will say. Are you all with me? So this is such an important question as far as examination is concerned. What I have done is, I have just classified it into in such a manner so that it becomes easy for you. The first three things pertains to date. The first three things pertains to date, where it is not dated or it is post dated or validity period has expired. The next six things relates to notice. It can be a notice of insolvency or notice of unsound mind or closure of account, whatever notice. And the next thing are the balance. These things we can use it. We can apply our common sense and then we can write it. Everyone?
Yes,